I know a place. Ain't nobody crying. Ain't nobody worried. No. Ain't no smiling faces. Mm-mm. No, no. Lying to the races. Help me. Come on. Come on. Somebody help me now. I'll take you there. Help me all.
Good afternoon, Wayne listeners, and welcome to Speaking of the Tongue, Words of Spiritual Poetic Inspiration. My name is Rita Harden, and I'm your hostess for this hour. I am also the author of a newly released book, Speaking of the Tongue, Words of Spiritual Poetic Inspiration. I'd like to start off, as I normally do, with a poem from my book. Poem is called Deliverance. I called on deliverance to rescue me. Did I forget that Jesus is He? I called on deliverance to take away my sins. I asked the Lord to reach inside deep within. My heart, my soul, to find what it is that has me captive, that won't let me live a Christ-like life, a life of love that's pure. I can't match my Lord's being, but I know this for sure, that being delivered is forgiveness of my sins and my past. To be delivered is a reason to have comfort and peace at last. Yes, I am a Christian, this I know, but my flesh, oh, how it wants to say no to the goodness and mercy and the grace that God has. I pray so hard for Him to deliver me from my past. Deliver me, O Lord, help me seek that place where Your goodness is added with Your grace. I humble myself. I ask for Your help. I pray to You to give me that need of heartfelt love, heartfelt joy, and heartfelt peace that brings a story to be told, a testimony at best, something grand, something new, shouting and rejoicing and giving praise to You. Oh, deliver me, O Lord. Take the binds off my feet. Release the tension that I feel whenever my heart beats. Stress comes over me, even pity too. Why should I ask for mercy from such a powerful God like You? Because I know You never change, and I know You love me so dear. And even when my eyes fill up with tears, I can look up to the heavens and know that You will be near, right there and ready to deliver me. Thank you for joining us this hour. As you know, this show is named after the book, Speaking of the Tongue. And for some of you who have been following the show regularly, my book, and those who have not, let me just tell you that the book is available at rosedogbooks.com or at amazon.com. We have an exciting show here for you today. We have our new talent competition of song, dance, music, and cultural art coming up. We also have your winners of the Oratory and Literary competition present, who will be announced today. Our special feature today is you, our Wayne listening audience, to participate in the selection of our winners for the song, dance, music, and cultural arts competition. That's right. You get to say, you get to have a say who wins in each category. All you have to do is to email your winner to info@waentv or to me at rah17009@bellsouth.net. So listen up, Wayne listeners. This is your chance to express your opinion and state your claim. We want to take this contest to a new level. You know, like a mini American Idol. Okay, we won't get that serious, you know. But anyway, everybody can call in, do an email, and pick your winner. We want to get your vote. We want you to choose your favorite youth or child that has touched your heart. So don't let me down. After all, I've just initiated all of you as judges for this competition. So let's get on with our show and get our praise on, shall we? We want to begin with Miss Wright, parent of one of our finalists for our oratory and literary competition. Miss Britney Wright, who authored the piece, Jesus in the Making, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Tell us, what do you think about this show, Speaking of the Tongue, and the programming so far?
I think it's a good experience for the youth and for them to display their talent, whichever talent they may have.
And as a parent to another parent, what would you say to encourage them to have their children and youth participate in this competition?
Just to encourage them to do whatever they choose, and support them.
And Ms. Wright, you're here today on behalf of your daughter,
yes,
Brittany, who had to work and couldn't be here, by the way. And for those of you who have been watching the show, the past few shows, if you remember Brittany coming and spewing her talents and the piece that she authored and wrote, which was just great, Jesus in the Making. We want to thank you for standing in the gap for Brittany today. And let's give Ms. Wright a round of applause. Mother of our finalists, Ms. Brittany Wright.
Thank you.
Okay. Before we announce the winners, let's hear from our other finalists here today. Miss Jordan Talley. Miss Jordan? Miss Jordan, how are you today?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you. Miss Jordan was interviewed on our third show and a co-host of our fourth show, where she read a poem from my book. She, too, is a finalist. And Miss Jordan, I understand you're secretary of your student council.
Yes.
Yeah. You want to tell us a little bit about that? I missed that last time you were here.
Like, if there's important stuff, we write the notes down, and we work with our meeting host, Miss Hawes, our counselor, and we write the notes down and type them on her computer for her.
Okay, well, that's a pretty big responsibility, isn't it?
Yes.
You enjoy doing it?
Yes.
Okay, all right. Well, how do you feel about being a finalist in this competition?
I feel excited, and I'm hoping to keep competing.
That sounds good to me. Did you think you'd get this far in the competition?
Yes.
Oh, well. Amen. And what advice would you give other kids who may be watching and they may be good at something and have a God-given talent? What would you tell them?
To be yourself and use the gift that God gave them.
Amen. 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 Thank you so much. Well, Jordan, we appreciate your participation in this competition, and we wish you the best of luck today.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Let me have a seat. Let's give Jordan a round of applause. Our last finalist is a young lady with a beautiful voice and a big heart, Miss Taylor Talley. Miss Taylor? Miss Taylor is a sixth grader at Cooper Middle School, and she volunteered and appeared for two shows and sung a well-known piece in a cappella, mind you, titled Rolling in the Deep by Adele. How are you, Miss Taylor?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. What a powerful piece, voice, and a very bright career you have to look forward to. Taylor, we want to thank you We want to thank you, and I can't tell you enough how much you helped us to fill in a lot of gaps here, and came and volunteered and brought your talent to Speaking of the Tongue at WAIN-TV. Taylor, talk with our listening audience for a minute and tell them your thoughts on the program.
Well, this program is an amazing program. What you do is you sing, dance, and express your talent and choose what you want to do and express it with us.
And would you tell other friends and even your kid and even kids your age about this program?
Yes.
Okay. Is there anything that you learned through this series of competition that stuck out in your mind or was important to you?
Yes. If you are afraid, don't give up. Give up. Don't ever give up. God is always with you.
Amen. Amen. Well, Taylor, we want to thank you for joining us and congratulate you for standing in the gap with us and debuting our second competition of song, dance, music, and cultural arts competition. And we look forward to hearing that wonderful voice again real soon, right?
Yes.
Okay, okay. Thank you. Let's give Taylor a round of applause. And finally, our last contestant, whom we just had here just a few minutes ago, is Miss Wright, who will be covering, will be here instead for Miss Brittany. And what I'd like to say is that I just can't say enough about all of the contestants that spent their time, their parents who believed in them and brought them here. Saturday after Saturday to promote not only the program but also themselves. And so we hope that we have, by I guess you could say, opening this avenue for children and youth to come in and show their God-given talent to the world, because let me tell you, WAIN.TV is a global internet station, so we do reach quite a few people around the world. So this is not just something that you see here locally. This reaches around the world, and we're so excited about having this kind of competition and this participation of young people to come here and do this with us, and we can't thank you all enough. What I'd like to do now is to call our finalists and our winners to the stage, because it's time to get paid. So we're going to begin with that, and I'm going to have everyone coming up. Just a minute, please. Thank you. I would like to call up Miss Wright. I would like to call up Miss Taylor and Miss Jordan, please. Miss Brittany, as I mentioned earlier, in speaking with her mother, read and authored the poem called Jesus in the Making. A very powerful piece for an 18-year-old. Well, Brittany's mom is here to represent her, Miss Wright. Our next finalist is Miss Jordan Taylor, who participated in the Oratory and Literary Contest, and she read a poem from my book called The Prince and the Princess. Miss Jordan Talley is also a finalist. Our third finalist is Miss Taylor Talley, who stood in the gap for us and sung an a cappella. Mind you, every time I start singing, you know, my husband tell me to keep my day job. What are you going to do? But Miss Taylor will be competing in the song, dance, music, and cultural arts competition, hopefully later on down the road. All right. Contestants, we want to thank you for competing in this oratory and literary contest and wish you the best of luck. Okay, here we go. Our third prize winner. Can we get a round of applause? Maybe a drum roll. Yay! Miss Taylor Talley. Miss Taylor, thank you. I asked her if she wanted to look in there and make sure the money was good. No checks, please.
You okay?
Yes, it's fine. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, Miss Taylor. Our second prize winner, Miss Jordan Talley. Talley. You good, right? $50 cash prize for Miss Jordan Talley. $25 cash prize for Miss Taylor. And our number one prize goes to Miss Britney Wright. $100 cash prize for her and her mother accepting that cash prize. No, don't run away now.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
You're very welcome. You're very welcome. And thank Britney for us again, please, for her coming. Now, you guys, I just want you to, again, I just want to thank you again for coming and doing what you did for me and this show. And I know our listening audience is excited now, right? Our listening audience is excited now. Our watching audience is excited now. We're going to get kids flooding through here. We're going to get kids flooding through here. I just know we are. Thank you, guys. Thank you again. Let's give them a round of applause. Okay. Thank you. You know, we want to thank all our winners for their participation, their courage, faith, and belief in themselves and in Christ for participating in our competition. And now it's time for us to begin our second competition. Today starts our competition for song, dance, music, and cultural arts competition. Today we have several competitors here with us to kick off this contest. So let's get our praise on, shall we? I would like you to join me in welcoming our first competitor today, Miss Alexis Means, an eighth grade student at King Middle School. Miss Alexis, how are you today?
I'm good, and you?
Fine, thank you. Miss Alexis, God has blessed you with a beautiful gift of oratory and creative skills. And I hear that you are also the youth council president of the NAACP. Is that right?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, that's just fantastic. And you're also, I believe, president of your student government association?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And let's not stop there. I tell you, we're hot today. Miss Alexis spoke before the General State Assembly on a piece she authored on the death penalty being abolished. Remarkable. This is just remarkable. Wow. What a gifted and talented young lady. God bless you.
Thank you.
Alexis, I just want to talk with you a moment, okay? Tell us a little bit about the piece you authored and spoke on before the Georgia State Assembly. And you can look right there in the camera and tell everyone.
Well, my project, Should the Death Penalty Be Abolished in Georgia, is a project about, well, first, the project came about when I was being a junior life member of the NAACP, and the Troy Davis case was around that time, so, and it was a time for us to pick our projects, so that kind of made me want to do a project on the death penalty being abolished in Georgia, and also it was for my Georgia Studies class, so that really would help me make it in Georgia. And so the project really came about after all the protests, and which still goes on today, even though Troy Davis was executed. But that's mainly how the project came about when I was doing protests and marches.
Okay. So that does kind of make it clear to us on your position as a youth of what you think about the death penalty. Is that correct?
Yes.
And tell us, what do you think about the death penalty?
Well, I believe the death penalty should be abolished because it goes against our Sixth Commandment and our Eighth Amendment. The Sixth Commandment, thou shalt not kill, and our Eighth Amendment, which is no cruel and unusual punishment. And it is cruel and unusual punishment.
Amen. Amen. Now, you also have an art and science project that I understand you're going to compete with in our cultural arts and music and song competition. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am.
And what is that science project, that art project?
The project is about cotton. Mm-hmm. When I was down in South Georgia at my great-grandmother's house, we saw a cotton field, so we picked the cotton plant, and I asked my dad, can we do a project on it? And he helped me with my board, and he helped me plant the cotton plant to keep it alive as I was doing the project. So basically, it was just giving a breakdown of what the cotton plant makes. It makes soaps, oils, Q-tips, as you may know, and lots of different things that we wouldn't think cotton makes mm-hmm. out of the material.
Very interesting.
So that really intrigued me. The cotton plant really intrigued me to want to do a project about it.
That's great. Now, you're competing right now. Is that correct? Or you're competing on the death penalty project? It's a state competition?
Yes, I will be going to the state competition on March 24th at Clark University for this project right here, and hopefully I'm going to go and do my best and win first place and take this trophy home back to my school as APS.
Amen. Well, we're rooting for you. Believe that. You let us know, and so we can plug in and tell all our friends on Facebook and YouTube, and we want you to win, so you have all our support on that. Thank you. What I'd like to do now is for you to, if you don't mind, to go ahead and talk about your piece that you have here on the death penalty.
Okay, so the purpose of me doing this project is because I want to know when the death penalty was established, is it effective, and does it deter crime? And I believe it should be abolished because, first, no man has a right to take another man's life. As I said, it goes against our Sixth Commandment and Eighth Amendment, and this is no one should have to die. So, as you can see, I have Troy Davis's face and Governor Deal's face up here, and you're probably wondering why I have their faces up here. The reason I have Mr. Troy Davis's face up here is because his case is the prime example why the death penalty should be abolished, and he is the face of the death penalty. And the reason I have Governor Deal's face up here is because he holds the highest executive seat in Georgia, and he had the power to stop the execution of Troy Davis. And as you can see here at the bottom, I have the three main execution methods: gas chamber, electric chair, and lethal injection. For right now, I feel that all of these are filed as cruel and unusual punishment. Take the gas chamber, for example. I have highlighted a few points at the bottom, and it says the patient goes through extreme horror and pain. Their eyes pop, their skin turns purple, and they begin to drool. So it's like they're actually dying from the cutting off of oxygen to their brain. So that's why I feel all of these are cruel and unusual punishment. So it's cruel and unusual punishment, and it does not deter crime. As you can see here, I have the top 14 states that have the death penalty and 14 states without. Murder rate is 141 to 108% higher in states that have the death penalty than in states without. And crime rate, as you can see here, is still higher in states with the death penalty than without. So it's cruel and unusual punishment. It does not deter crime, and it kills innocent people. The reason I say that, because there have been a total of 138 exonerations since 1973, five of them which were in Georgia. So that means evidence had came about to show that these people were innocent. What if they were executed? That means we will let our government murder 138 innocent people. So it's cruel and unusual punishment. It is not effective, and it does not deter crime. It kills innocent people, and right here, more people have asked me, is there a alternative to the death penalty? And there was a poll taken, and it shows that 40% of people say they prefer life without parole, and only 33% say they prefer the death penalty. So it shows that America is more towards abolishing the death penalty than keeping the death penalty. And it shows right here it's also racially biased, because if there was a white defendant and a black victim, only 17 people got the death penalty. And there was a black defendant and a white victim, 255 people got the death penalty. So it's showing us that they care for one's race more than the other. So we cannot have that. So it's cruel and unusual punishment. It is not effective and does not deter crime. It kills innocent people and is used in a racially biased system. At the bottom, I have some powerful opinions by famous leaders, and one of them says, right here, by Pun Jar the Pope, "The death penalty is both cruel and unnecessary. The dignity of human life must never be taken, even in the case of someone who has done great evil." So even great leaders and powerful leaders say that this should be abolished, and that's the main reason why I think the death penalty should be abolished in Georgia.
You are amazing. This is amazing. I mean, the knowledge and the research that you have done here. Let me ask you, on the research, where did you get most of your material on this? How did you come about with coming up with your program there?
I got most of my information from deathpenaltyinfo.org and Amnesty International, where I got some of my graphs. And for my project, I'm also filming a documentary to go with it.
Oh, man, that's wonderful.
Yeah, so I have traveled all over Georgia, mainly in Columbus. I've been there twice, interviewing people from the state capitol, mm-hmm. like Tyrone Brooks and President DeBose,
okay.
of the state president of the NAACP, and my pastor, which is the Atlanta branch NAACP president, Dr. R.L. White Jr.
Okay.
So I've interviewed them and been to different conferences, and I'm just recording all this information and putting it into my documentary, because I know students my age wouldn't think about doing things like that. Mm-hmm. And that's what I think that makes me different about my project.
And would you encourage or do you talk with other students who may show an interest in doing this kind of thing? Would you be helpful with them and getting them on the ground and getting them started with projects of this nature, or of anything for that matter?
Yes, because I feel they should join the NAACP
first.
Start with it, because mm-hmm. if they join the NAACP, they can see the things that people like me see by mm-hmm. being a Junior Life member of the NAACP. Mm-hmm. So they can see the things, and then they want to fight for what's right.
That's
instead
right.
of not knowing
That's
about
absolutely
it.
Absolutely right.
And just going through the motion. Mm-hmm. So I think they should start off by joining NAACP. And then from there, we can help them progress on to fight for what's right.
Brittany, I'm sorry. Alexis, I just can't tell you how impressed I am with what you have here and what you're doing and what you're going to do. And these are the kinds of things that God blesses us with each and every day. Gifts and talents and a heart that looks for the wrong, the right, the good things, the bad, being able to serve people, love people, and do the things that you're doing right now. At such a young age, you're going to be such a powerful young lady. I'm almost afraid to say. I can't imagine looking at you and calling President Alexis Means. How does that sound to everybody? Sound pretty good to me. Yes, yes. So we really, we appreciate you, Alexis. I would like, before you leave, to tell us a little bit about your duties with the NAACP.
Well, right now we have three main things that we want to see accomplished to start off with. First is to increase our youth membership by mm-hmm. having membership drives. And on March the 20th at my school, at our Let's Get Engaged rally, we will have our first membership drive there to also help raise our mm-hmm. membership. Secondly, we would like to see is voter education. Mm-hmm. To educate students on how to vote and how important it is to vote, even though we're not old enough now.
Right.
But when the time comes, we can be prepared
and ready
to vote.
And yes. ready, exactly.
Because many people have mm-hmm. died, so we can have the right to vote, and we must take advantage of
That's
it.
That's right. That's right.
And so I feel, and my dad, since he's the membership chair of the Atlanta branch and the mm-hmm. criminal justice chair of the state of Georgia, mm-hmm. he put together a program called Roll to the Pole. So basically, this program will follow the students all the way till they're old enough to vote, remind them how important it is to vote, and to keep them fresh on their mind on how to vote as well.
Well, this sounds just fantastic, and I hope that you will definitely let these young people at your school know about our show here, and also encourage them. We can help you through our show to promote registration and involvement and enrollment in the youth NAACP. We want to do that. As you can see, our show is basically we do all youth competition. We do anything that youth would like to do. We welcome anything, anybody with a talent, with a gift, with an interest to come to our show, and we want to be able to help you and the NAACP in any way that we can here on WAIN-TV and Speaking of the Tongue.
Mm-hmm. And our third thing we would like to see is to establish a charter in every high school and maybe even middle school, because this will keep this will help students who are in middle school mm-hmm. get transferred on to high school.
Sure.
In the high school charters, and then they go to the college charters, and then they'll go to the local branches, and then this will be a continuous cycle, so the youth will keep on the legacy of the NAACP.
Yeah, and that has to hold and stay strong. With the NAACP and your participation in it, you're at King Middle School, is that correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and at King Middle School, do you have a number of students that are already members of the NAACP, or is this what you're focused on now, getting this going?
Right now, we're focused on getting this going, okay. Getting more students signed up at my school.
Okay, and then it can be taken to other schools as well, and getting other students interested, because what I like and what I heard, the part that I heard about with you, you spoke about preparing to vote, preparing and being educated on the voting process, the political process, because again, our young people are the people who are going to be coming up and making those decisions in the political arena very, very soon. I mean, you're an eighth grader, we're talking maybe what,
4 years?
4 years, and you'll be able to step out there and go in that booth and make some kind of decisions. And so in preparation of that, that's for me, that there is just awesome. I want to know if there would be information that you would be able to provide me with that we can continue to promote here on the show in terms of voter education, in terms of youth joining the NAACP on the youth side.
Well, I encourage the parents when they go to vote in the election in November to take their children with them mm-hmm. and to wait into that voting process, so they can see what the process is to vote. Even though it may be 2 hours or 4 hours you have to wait in line,
yes.
They can already experience that voting process. So when it's time for them to vote, they can already know that this is what it's going to be like mm-hmm. when it's time for us to vote. So I really encourage parents to do that by taking their students to the vote, because I know my dad, he took me to the primary election
mm-hmm.
and he made even though it wasn't that long, but mm-hmm. I actually got to see the voting process mm-hmm. of how to vote.
How often do you meet with the NAACP, with the youth council meet? Do you have regular meetings, or is there certain times that you meet, or
Right
and is
now,
it open for youth to come in and
yes.
say, hey, I want to join, I want to be a part of this?
Mm-hmm. It's open for youth to come in and sign up whenever they feel like it. Right now, we will try to have a meeting twice a month at mm-hmm. least. Mm-hmm. So it'll be every other week. Mm-hmm. We actually don't have an exact date right now, but we're mm-hmm. trying to get it in between this month mm-hmm. so we can actually know our membership, who will be on our membership team working with me.
Okay.
As well.
And I take it you have a Facebook page. I don't know what kid does it. I don't know. And so do you talk a lot about this project? Do you talk a lot about the participation and your part in as president of the Youth Council of the NAACP? Do you do any encouragement through your avenue of the Facebook?
Yes, but right now I have to upload all my pictures from my events because I be so busy and I really don't have time to upload so pictures like I can.
That's fine.
But when I get a chance, yes, I will upload all my pictures from my accomplishments.
Sure. And people. Please don't forget about us and stay in touch with us and let us know how we can help here on the show. As I said, I'm very open to this is my husband and I, this is what we do. We try to work with youth. We do whatever we can in the community, and we want to be a part of anything that will be positive and that can help you and your efforts. And I thank you again for coming to the show.
Okay, and I thank you for having me out here.
Okay, thank you, dear. Let's give her applause, because, I mean, this is an awesome young lady, huh? You know, I just want to say that I'm just overwhelmed in joy and full of joy. My heart is full of joy because, you know, Wayne listeners, how I've been begging every single show. You guys probably get tired of me begging. You stop eating your popcorn, for God's sake. I don't know. But I've been begging for youth to come here to this show and parents to bring them to the show and participate to see how important it is to have an avenue where your children can express their gifts and show their talents. It's not a lot. This is not a show on TV, but it's a show here on WAIN.TV, a web TV internet broadcast station. And as I said, that reaches many. And there's a number of shows that are broadcast here throughout the week from Monday through Friday, seven days a week. There are a number of different type shows. But I just want to thank WAIN-TV, Mr. Jackson, Ms. Craig, for their sponsorship in helping us to promote and put this program together with youth competing. We're not done yet. I'd like to introduce another young lady, if she will come up. And there she is, Ms. Shanta. And we're going to talk with her a little bit. She's another competitor. And please forgive me that I don't have a lot of information, because I know you just walked in with me and volunteered more or less, and we appreciate you being here. And please tell us your name, tell us your school, and what you do. Okay?
Okay, my name is...
Is it on?
My name is Santianna Wright. I am a senior at South Atlanta Computer Animation and Design. I will be graduating at the 10% of my class.
Oh, amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. I am the parliamentarian in an organization named Divas. I also participate in a youth mentoring organization named TAG. I also participate in the SGA. I'm the parliamentarian of that as well.
Okay. Now, what is the, you said the youth, say that again, I'm sorry.
TAG.
What is that?
We just started it at our school, a group of girls.
Mm-hmm.
We help the younger students, juniors, seniors. We start at second grade and
mm-hmm.
up.
Mm-hmm.
It's about helping them stay in school, continue to be focused.
Good.
And just because, you know, they have obstacles and things, you know, that get in their way,
mm-hmm.
we try to encourage them not to give up.
That's right. That's what we do right here. So we appreciate you.
Yeah.
And you're doing that. Now, this school, it's a different, it's not a public school.
It is. APS. APS school.
Okay. I'm just old. What do I know?
Yeah.
This is a new school to me, the name of it. Say that name of that school again.
South Atlanta Computer Animation and Design.
Does that sound like an Atlanta public school? Okay, good. All right. Go ahead, dear.
I am a teenage mother.
Okay.
My daughter, her name is Serenity Wright. I named her Serenity because during the time that I got pregnant, I was going through a lot of things, and I think it was God's way of telling me that I need to slow down.
Okay.
And I named her Serenity because it gave me peace.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she gave
mm-hmm.
me peace. I began to do better in school because
Wonderful.
At first, I'm not going to lie, I was I was a mess. I was all over the place. I wasn't focused where I needed to be. And when I found out that I was pregnant with her, it told me that she can't live that life where she sees her mother struggling, living off the government, which, you know, some people, you know, they're forced to do that. Mm-hmm. But I didn't want her to live that life. Mm-hmm. I want her to see her mother be successful. Even though I did become a teenage mother, you know, at a young age, I want her to see me graduate from high school, see me graduate from college. I've sent out a lot of college letters, applications, and I've received a lot of them back as well.
Okay.
I have a 3.0 as Wonderful. My grade point average at
all
school.
All right, all right.
I'm in the beta club.
Okay.
So it was a lot of hard work, and it still is.
Yes.
With, you know, mm-hmm. a young child, and I'm still a child as well. But I'm in the adult choir at my church.
And what church is that?
Faith Baptist.
Okay.
Yes, and we all... It's a lot of things that we do there. I participated in the youth ministries, and we go on trips, mm-hmm, and mm-hmm. yeah.
Yeah, well, you know what? I mean, I take my hat off to you because you're honest, and you come up, and you talk about your life's challenges and mm-hmm. the fact that you are a mother now, even though you're still young and still in school, but mm-hmm. you have some goals, you've made up your mind of the direction you want to go into, mm-hmm. and that's really important, and I wish you the best of luck in that and sticking with that, and I know that your daughter will be able to see the fruits of that once you graduate from college and from high school and go on to college, which as you said you plan to do, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. Now you're here today to do some singing, I understand.
Yes.
Is you sure you can sing? Because yes, if you sound like me, like my husband tell me, go sit down somewhere. So you say you can sing, huh?
Yes.
All right. What are you gonna sing for us?
I Trust You by James Fortune.
All right. And you're gonna do it in a cappella.
Yes.
Boy, I like this a cappella stuff. Okay. Here she is, man. And when you're in your name again, your first name again,
Santianna
Wright.
Again, I will be singing I Trust You by James Fortune and Fire. Even though I can't see and I can't feel your touch, I will trust you, Lord, how I love you so much. Though my nights may seem long, and I feel so alone, Lord, my trust is in you. I surrender to you. So many painful thoughts travel through my mind, and I wonder how I will make it through this time, but I'll trust you. I need to know you're here. Through the tears and the pain, through the heartache and rain, Lord, I'll trust you. Everything that I see tells me not to believe, but I'll trust you, Lord. You have never failed me. My past still controls me. Will this hurt ever leave? I can only trust you. No one loves like you do. But I'll trust you. Lord, I need to know you're here. Through the tears and the pain, through the heartache and rain, Lord, I'll trust you. Thank you.
You've got a pretty powerful voice there, young lady. And we certainly enjoyed that, and you understand, I don't know if you had Brittany, as a matter of fact, Brittany is the one who recruited you, huh?
Yes, that's my cousin.
Yeah, and she suggested that you come on and join the, get involved in the competition, and we certainly appreciate it, and we hope that you'll come back, because you'll need to if you plan to continue to compete in our finalists. Contest. So I thank you again for coming and joining us. We appreciate you, and keep up the good work, and keep your head focused where you're going, where you're talking about going, so that you can get where you want to be in Christ. Yes.
Thank you as well.
Thank you. I would like to speak briefly here, and because in our closing, last week we talked about your participation, Wayne listeners. We need you as judges for this competition and future competitions, and we want you to vote your heart, who touched you, and you choose a winner. You need to send your vote to info at WAENTV, and we will let you know when the voting process will start on the show. And by the way, we have a program change for next Saturday. As you know, this show is usually from 1 p.m. until 2 p.m. However, next Saturday we will be on at 6 p.m. on March 24th, 2012, where we will have competitors who unfortunately cannot be here at our 1 p.m. show. So we did a program change just for them because they are in school, art schools, art and cultural schools during this time. So we hope you'll be able to join us for our next group of competitors, and that's going to be an exciting show. Also, we will begin our Mother's and Father's Day contest. Now, if you remember, when my husband was here on the fourth show and filled in for me, he mentioned to everyone about the 100-word essay, Youth, writing a 100-word essay on why my husband, Chef Elton, should come to your home and cook your mother or your dad a Father's Day meal, 7-course meal. We need essays on this project. Now, there's no cost to you. All you need is some pots and pans in the kitchen. And my husband will come in and we'll bring in everything and we'll do the rest. But we do need entries for that. And if you want to go online to info at waen.tv and get a registration form, I can just briefly show you. You probably won't be able to see it that well, but this is the flyer. And it does say, listen up, all young blessed executive chefs. Join us and compete for our Mother's Father's Day essay contest. Your challenge is to write a 100-word or less essay on why your parents deserve a 7-course meal that will be prepared by me at your home with all the blessing from the Lord. Amen. So the Mother's Day contest will begin on April 1st. Now, all contestants have to come to the show and read their essay. And again, we are not going to be the judges here. Possibly my husband, because he's going to, you know, pay for everything. But we also want to ask our Wayne listeners to help us by emailing again and voting. So the Father's Day contest. Now, the Mother's Day contest will end on, let's see what we have here. Winner will be selected on May 5th. So the finalists will appear here on the 22nd, and Mother's Day is on the 11th, and we will pick the winners on May 5th, and dinner will be served at some mother's house on May 11th. Now, on the Father's Day contest, that will begin on May 12th, and the winner will be selected on June 9th, and dinner will be served for some lucky dad and his wife on June 17th. Now, we're talking a 7-course meal, no cheap stuff, okay? My husband says he'll provide a menu that you can select from for your entree. The other courses he will provide. So this should be exciting, because just put a plate on the side for me. I don't know. I may come too. But again, as I said, all contestants will need to appear on Speaking of the Tongue. And you can also email your essay to my husband's email address, which is chefelton5@bellsouth.net. chefelton5@bellsouth.net. So act and do a good deed today for your parents, and I know that God will bless you for that. Okay, yes, here we go. You know what I'm going to say, folks. I'm excited. We have a wonderful spring and summer series of contests for our Youth Pack members. Youth Pack meaning youth poets and artists in Christ. I would like to, I also want to mention a couple other quick things here. I don't know if you listeners and viewers have noticed, but there's something missing on this show with this competition. And I'm going to tell you what it is. We have had no young men compete so far. I tell you what, I know there's some young men out there who can compete with these talented young ladies. I'm just saying. So dads, moms, friends, and youth ministers, you know what it is. We need to see all our youth represented. Amen. We need to see all our youth. So please bring in some of these young brothers to come on the show. If they rap, it's okay with me. They know what it is. I know there's some good Christian rap out there. There's some good regular rap out there. There's some wonderful rap out there. And there's some great songs too. So we do need Boy Scouts come in with projects, whatever it might be. We need some young men. So here I am again begging. I know y'all get tired of hearing me beg, but it's working though. Look what we had today. Aren't you excited? I am. I'm excited. So I would like to also mention again a big, big thank you for my friend Luchin Goggins, you know, for his wonderful support in promoting this project and with me and helping me to get this thing off the ground. And he is a true activist in the community. And he is just a wonderful, wonderful person to know. And I just want to thank you again, Lucian, for all you've done and all you're going to do. Because I know you're going to do some more, right? Yeah. But let me show you one thing very quickly here that may spark some of those. That may spark some of those youth to come out and participate. Males. The first male that shows up here is going to win this t-shirt. My t-shirt. Speaking of the tongue. This t-shirt right here. They're going to win it. That's just a given. They're just going to come in and get that. So we need that first male to walk in the door. Okay. And I need to hear from you guys. So please get your people in. Again, as I said, they can win this first t-shirt. We're going to try to put this up again so you can take a look at it. Just a minute, please. This first t-shirt right here. Speaking of the tongue, words of spiritual poetic inspiration, book authored by myself, Rita Harden. So we want to get this t-shirt to somebody. The first young man that comes in. I would like to end the program again with, as you saw last Saturday, some of the pieces that we have done, my brother had done for us. He's just a genius. He too, like Mr. Goggins, is a wonderful, wonderful partner in this program and getting things off the ground and helping me to promote this book and this show. So if you just give us just a brief minute, we're going to present these pieces to you again. Thank you. This one. thank you for your patience on this. Again, as I talked with you last week, we talked about Moses' pieces. And, you know, it's good for us to have artwork as we create the, as we continue with our series on songs, dance, and art competition. And my brother has just been a wonderful, wonderful person in helping me to promote this show and bring in pieces that would relate to what we do here on Speaking of the Tongue. As you can see here, he has the piece, Tune In, Speaking of the Tongue, WAIN-TV, Saturdays 1 to 2 p.m. This is Moses and the staff, John 3:16. This piece here is Speaking of the Tongue Show. Again, Youth Pack, Youth Poets and Artists in Christ. Moses again coming down the mountain with all the kids hanging out, working their way to the show. I just think it's some great art. Also, the piece here that we have, and let me just pull that out. This piece is showing all of our youth coming into the studio, ready to do their thing, right? Participate in our youth competition. Our other pieces include this one, which we did flyers on, asking everyone, youth poets and artists in Christ with God-given talent, to come in and participate in our show. And this was for the oratory and literary competition that we did during Black History Month. And then our final piece here is related to our competition that we're doing right now, the Song and Dance Arts Music Cultural Competition. Stating, do you like to read, write poetry, songs sent to you through Christ? If so, join us. Have you heard there's a new show that Express Ourselves, Speaking of the Tongue? So, again, we just want to let everybody know that there's a avenue here for you all. If you can get your kids in here for us. And we had just such an amazing show today. I tell you, Miss Alexis, just a powerful, powerful piece. Let's give her another round of applause. I mean, just an absolute powerful piece on the death penalty why it should be abolished. Her activism with the NAACP and with working with youth. It's just phenomenal what our young people can do. And I can't imagine how elated her parents are, and the hard work and what they put into it for her to see her to get to this level. I thank you. I thank your parents, Alexis. I thank you guys for coming. I thank you guys for supporting your children like you do. This is what we're talking about here. And a lot of times we don't get a chance to show what we do or to let our kids express themselves and be a part of a dream that could be. As I read to you, I think last week in the book, about being Christ-like, not wanting to be a wannabe, but being Christ-like and following a dream that could be. We also want to thank our wonderful young lady that came and sang, I'll Be True. I mean, this is just fantastic. And she told a great story to us about her life and how she's making changes and how we've all been there, done that. We can't be judges of anyone cannot be a judge of anyone else. And we know that if once we realize what we've done in our lives, what we can do in our lives, and we know that Christ is there with us, shining that light on us, making us believers, keeping our faith strong, anything is possible if God's willing. I want to thank everyone again for being a part of this show. Thank you for coming. And we'll see you next Saturday at 6 p.m. Good night, and God bless you, and may God keep you.